And out front now, Alexandria Ocasio-Cortez. So, I mean, as I was saying to you before, whatever people think of your politics, your tenacity and passion are something everyone should be excited about and proud of, as your rival clearly was. What do you think about this? Just when you say this is, it just shows money isn't everything.
Yeah.
He outraced you 10 to 1.
Yeah.
Money didn't matter.
No, it didn't. And I think that, you know, money is important in running a lot of races, and historically it's been a major predictor in who does win a race. But, you know, if you really understand your community, if you really know how to navigate things, and I come from the background as an educator and as an organizer, when you really know a community, I think that it can give you a good enough edge to win.
So now your platform, obviously, you, when you were an organizer, in part, at one point you were organizing for Bernie Sanders.
Yes.
Then you started running yourself. Your plans include abolishing ICE, Jason was going through some of these, a universal health care, as you call Medicare for all, guarantee of a job for people who want one, free college tuition. Do you think even your Democratic colleagues will support that platform?
Well, I think that they've already started. There are plenty who have already hopped on board. You know, there already is legislation on the floor of Congress regarding the abolishment of ICE. Leading Democratic leaders like Kamala Harris and even folks like Pramila Jayapal have already discussed this issue. We have a very large amount of co-sponsors on the Medicare for All legislation, you know, among the Democratic caucus. So I do think that a lot of this legislation points to the America that we want to have. And I think that there's a willingness to work on these issues and get closer to that point.
So how are you going to learn everything you need to know? You don't have a lot of time.
Right, right.
And obviously it's a Democratic district. So the presumption is you're heading down there. So what do you do now to learn everything you need to do, to sponsor legislation, to write the bills, to actually take these ideas and put them somewhere?
Well, everyone in Congress has been a freshman at some point. Yeah. And so I'm confident in my ability to navigate and learn these ropes. I feel very, very welcomed by many of the Democratic incumbents right now. We've received phone calls from senators and current incumbents welcoming me to the delegation and to the party. And so I feel very embraced by many of these individuals, and I feel like we'll be able to make it work.
Okay, so a couple of the individuals who are going to make your life more difficult on the Democrat and Republican side, let's start with Mitch McConnell. Okay, he says your win is indicative of the direction of the Democratic Party as a whole, implying that it's going all the way to socialism. Here he is.
It was a stunning development. The energy in the Democratic Party is self-avowed socialists, open borders. I think it's a general election problem for them in a number of places and a real drag on the party in terms of appealing to American voters who I don't think want us to turn into a European socialist country.
Are you a drag on the Democratic Party?
No. I so many people across the country are inspired by this win and inspired about this race because of what it represents. It represents possibility. It represents a potential future. You know, and there are other members in Congress that identify themselves. You know, you have Bernie Sanders that carried very strongly in the Midwest. And really, this is not about labels. This is not about left versus right divisiveness. This is about top and bottom. This is about speaking about healthcare, education, housing, wages for working class Americans, criminal justice reform, and more. And people listen to that message, and you can't scare people, you know, with a label. You know, you could say that the president is an authoritarian, hyper-capitalist, but at the end of the day, what does that mean? And when we talk about the issues, as long as we can build consensus around the issues, nothing else really matters.
So Nancy Pelosi has, you know, also come out. Look, she's said some good things, too, but also sort of implying, okay, that's great, but it's just one little place. It's just nothing to worry about, everybody. Nothing to see here. Here she is.
They made a choice in one district. So let's not get yourself carried away as an expert on demographics and the rest of that.
Yeah, well, you know, I think that we're in the middle of a movement in this country. I feel this movement, but that movement's going to happen from the bottom up. That movement is going to come from voters. There are a lot of really exciting races with extremely similar dynamics as mine. It's not just one district. You look at Ayanna Pressley out in Massachusetts. Same exact situation.
So here's the thing, though. Nancy Pelosi's 78. You are 28.
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm.
We can do the math. Okay.
Yeah.
So, Steny Hoyer, the minority whip, 79. Jim Clyburn, 77.
Yeah.
Okay. Yeah. Is that going to stay that way? Can someone like Nancy Pelosi, and this isn't about her as a human being, this is about the leader of your party when it comes to Congress. Is it time for new blood? Younger blood.
You know, I do think that we do need to elect a generation of new people to Congress on both parties. You know, I think that some of the issues that we even have today may have to do with some of the calcified structures and relationships. And, you know, in certain seats where it's appropriate, I think that a new leaf can actually mean a lot of opportunity for the party and our future.
That's interesting, the calcified. That's an interesting word to use. But, I mean, that is part of the problem, right? You have a lot of people who are a different generation than the people they represent.
Yeah, and this is about diversity as well. And, you know, we have to have a diversity of age as in Congress represented, too.
So, you know, you told CNN earlier today you did support the impeachment of President Trump. Bernie Sanders, obviously, you worked for him. He was asked specifically to respond to your comments, and I just want to play for you what he said.
Sure.
I'm a member of the United States Senate. I'm going to have to be, if impeachment proceedings go forward, I'm going to be judging on that. So it's premature to me to be calling for his impeachment. Second of all, we have the Mueller investigation, which is ongoing, and I think it'll be, from my perspective, jumping the gun.
Do you see him as a mentor? Do you say, okay, maybe I went too far on that, or no?
You know, I am so willing and open. You know, what we do is we build consensus, and that is what governance is all about, you know? I may have a certain opinion. You know, I think that the president has more than enough action for us to kind of investigate these things. You know, you look at what the Republicans voted on impeachment with Bill Clinton, and it seems like, you know, as we say in the Bronx, seems like papitas compared to this current administration. But I am absolutely willing to work with, you know, work with our incumbents in our administration. I am a new and freshman member of Congress, and I look forward to building those relationships. And at the end of the day, it's about getting things done.
So after losing last night, we had played briefly, Jason played the end of his piece, Congressman Crowley, doing something, frankly, that I think would be, you know, it's a heartbreaking moment for him, you have to imagine. Here's, again, what he did. How did that make you feel?
It makes me emotional just watching it. To handle that moment with such grace, and I mean, I have a profound amount of respect. I do. I have a profound amount of respect for the service that he's had for our community, and you know, I just think it was beautiful, and I look forward to building that relationship as well.
Have you talked to him? Because he obviously could be a crucial person for
you. Absolutely. You know, we've been trying to get in contact. You know, in a way, yesterday I was a constituent, and how do you find your congressman's personal cell phone number? We're looking for it, but we've been reaching out, and I greatly look forward to having that conversation.
So you don't have a cell phone number yet?
No, we're working on it. We're working on it.
All right. Well, I'm sure he will take the call.
Yeah.
And your line has probably been busy through much of the day.
Yeah, my phone is bricked.
All right. Well, thank you so much. I appreciate it. And I hope everyone watching, again, agree with her or disagree with her, is inspired by the fact that you can come from behind and from nowhere in this country and still go into public service.